folks, another video, and we're going to start with tea. Seems to be a good little exercise, starting with tea. It's another one of my mugs, and this one is a Kilty Goth mug actually. So got the name I was used there, and this bloody cup's hot. Goth after 30, the Kilty Goth. Just makes your tea taste have a lot better. Better not put that down and let it get flipping cold, because when you get a good cup of tea, it's not a bloody good idea wasting it. Just want to show you a couple of things I've bought today, and then a couple of little goffy tips that you can make with rubbish that you got. Sort of based on the idea, if anybody watched the video where I showed you the little spiders in the hand gel. If you didn't see it, go and look for it. Anyway, what I bought today wasn't out to buy anything today, and that's how it flipping goes. But what did I get first? Ooh, yes. These went into one shop. I was looking for a little sugar thing, really, and came across those. No, they're not dynamite, they're candles. 2, 3, 4. Funny, there's 5 in that one. And there's 6 in that one. 50p a bunch. So for £1, there's some pretty blooming decent candles, I would say. So I wasn't intending on getting those, but for 50 pence a bunch, you can't flipping walk away, can you? Went into another shop, saw this on the shelf, and there's a bit missing. I'll take the candle out because it wasn't in there. And it's this, if you can see it. I'm not really into the fairies and all that sort of thing. Not that I don't like them, it's just skeletons and all that sort of thing is my thing. But this is pretty flipping heavy. It's like a pewter. Got that for £2, and I imagine a lot of you have guessed what it is. Well, it's this, for those that didn't. Tea light goes into said hole. And obviously, I'm assuming, like this from my other one, it's missing something like this that would have set on the top. And oils or wax melts, crystals, whatever, that takes the heat and makes your room pong nice. This was not there. That belongs to another one. So it was said item. But for £2 again, and chunky, you can't not have it. Now you could either wait till you come across another one with a saucer on the top sort of thing, dish, that is very basic and pretty horrible. Buy it cheap and put the glass on here. Or you could put a candle that size that's about that tall in the middle. That would look pretty neat. Or you can do what I'm probably going to do, and I had one or two of these little glass candles around, so it just happens to drop in there, so I shall use that for now. And I'm assuming by the thickness and whatever this, and the fact that it does have a candle in it, that that'll take that little bit of heat from a tea light, I shall find out. But for now, that was sitting there, and when possible, I shall buy the dish. Might even have a look online, see if you can actually buy the glass dishes cheap. So that was the second thing today. Did I buy anything else? Oh yeah, this is what I bought today. I'm just a crazy flipping. Went in a shop, they had some of these hanging up. Said to the woman, what are they? What did she call them? Scarves. Now you can tell me whether it's a scarf or not. They're £1 each, and it looks like that. It's all ruffled. The back, it's slightly different colour, as like a backing, and it's springy. Now it could be a scarf, it's that long. Come on, ladies, especially, you know what it is. I don't know what it is, but I liked it. What did I think when I saw it? I thought dead, and I thought coffins. That's the way my flipping mind works. Doesn't that just look like something that belongs to a coffin? Either like my coffee table here, if I took the lid off, that would be really nice round the top of the inside. That'd be really flipping neat. You could even have the top bit hanging over the lid. On the other hand, you could put it on the outside, just under the lid. I would probably drop that top bit down to that there, and then if I could be bothered, I might just pin it to the side so you can get an idea what it looks like. But don't go and put any bets on it, because I might not be freaking bothered. Anyway, ladies, you might know what this is. It does something, and £2 a bit. I just bought two because I thought I'm going to do something with the bloody things. So if it's not coffin wise, it will end up adorning around my place. Plus I've got there what I call my coffin shelves, which is like 1, 2, 3, 4 coffin lids. There's a stack of shelves. So would I put it round those? Possibility. Might hide everything though. But yeah. So really, that was the bits I bought today, just because I see them and I can't bloody walk away. But it's not a bad thing when you buy loads of these little things. When good bits come along, they remember you, and that crazy bloke will have this. Nobody else will have it. That crazy bloke will. No, they don't really think that. Talking about crazy. Just a little story before I go on to the next bit. Quite a while now, little kids, some big kids, all seem to flippin' think I'm a pirate. I know today I've got the skull and crossbones, and there's a little bit down the back and that sort of thing. Come in, walking out of a big superstore, this little kid about that tall off the ground. Must have been with parents, and must have gone, go and get him, boy. Come running up the side of me, pirate, pirate, to stop me. And a little high five, which I thought was really flipping cute. But he just wanted to come and high five the pirate. Just amazing. Even if I don't wear this, with any of the kids think I'm a flipping pirate. I don't know whether the kilt looks like the coats they wear that go out a little bit, and the boots, but I'm a pirate. Can't be bad. Who can complain about being Johnny Depp every day? Johnny Depp's granddad. Right, now to the last bit. Some little ideas if you want to do them. If you don't bother. But it's like I said the other day, we all have little bits from Halloween, we have them left over, and these little bits pop up every Halloween. You don't have to think to yourself, oh, please be on the shelves, because I want them like you do some things. Some years you get a really nice tall skeleton, and the next year, oh, bugger. These are there all the time. And the little bags of spiders and everything, sometimes a little different sizes. The other day I did a video and I showed you how to put them in a bottle of hand gel, and they'll sit there suspended in the hand gel. And depending on what ones you got, you can really look through them and find the best looking real spiders that you can. Push them through the lid, and I forgot to say the other day, if you want, because they're suspend, if you want them to be sort of halfway down the gel or something, get a pencil or anything that's thin, and just poke around in there till you sort of get it into the position you want, and within reason that will stay there till the gel sort of runs down to there. But not if you bang the bottle around, it'll drop down a bit. Anyway, there's a couple of little ideas which I did a long time before the gel, actually. And this was the first one. There'll be lots of you out there if you're not someone that's got bad eyes like, and has contacts for that reason, like I do. I can have one for reading. You'll all have these little bottles, possibly. My last lot are not, but sometimes you get these little bottles, contacting each one. Well, this is the first thing I did. Just put some water in it. Get this the right way around. Little tiny, can you see? Little tiny spider. Put it in there, and it looks like a little spider specimen, like you might have even caught your spider yourself and thought, going there, you little bugger. But it is plastic. No spider was killed in the filming of this. It is an Halloween one. But it just looks like a little spider. And I actually just did two of those, and they sit in the bathroom somewhere, because my bathroom's called the Chapel of Rest. Chapel of Restroom. So it's a bit deady. So on a little thing on the wall, two of those sit. On the little windowsill in the bathroom, I kept some bottles that size, which had paste in, like you buy fish paste, meat paste, all that it was used up. Now in these I put water, and I wanted them to look a bit different to just plain clear like that. So I can't remember what I put in. I just put something in that would change the colour a little bit, make it look a bit like sort of formaldehyde with a decomposed creature in it. Anyway, so this on the top, I painted the lid black, and then this little bobble on the top was, you can use the top of a toothpaste tube or anything, glue it on, paint it all black. And there is a bigger, I can't see, can you see it? There's a bigger chunky spider. And again, it looks like a specimen that I've either bought or, well, I'd have had to have bought because if you saw a spider that size in Britain, you'd crap yourself. I've seen some biggish ones, but with bloody legs and that like that, I'd be bloody going, what the freaking hell's that? That's one. Here's another one. I've sort of messed this up a bit, but let's use this hand. But you see, there's another spider in there. That's a little bit clearer. So I've got spiders and such. You can use other things, other bugs, but you can make yourself a little selection of, can't remember what they call them, wet specimens, which is like little dead creatures that are kept in preservative. If you don't like to keep the real dead article, do something like that. You know what it is, it's a bit of fun. But you can put it around, you can have it in your living room, you can put it in your bathroom, you can put it in the guest bedroom. It's just a bit of fun. For you know that people are going to come in, think you're freaky any bloody way, but if they don't like spiders, actually you're probably going to get, could you just take them out of this bloody room while a minute? And the other bit, which is a little bit more crazier really, I did this a couple of years ago. I can't remember what was in this jar. It was probably pickles or something, which sort of goes with the theme, doesn't it? But they were selling these plastic hands in Poundland, actually. The rubber, they look pretty realistic. So I thought I'll get a couple. And this one went into this jar. I don't know if you can see that, how well you can see it. I did want it to be a bit goffy, so I did paint the nails black. But there you go. It's a pretty realistic looking hand, and it's in the jar. And for quite a while, I did have some liquid in here. But I was getting a bit worried that whatever this is, plastic, rubber, or whatever, was going to react to that, and I was going to end up with some weird bloody solution in there. You don't really need it. It looks pretty neat. Now, that one actually sits in the living room over there on the coffin shelves. But yeah, you know, a little bit of imagination. And you can have your own exhibits. I suppose you could have this for real. Cost you a bloody fortune. But that looks pretty real to me. And actually, there is one on the... I said I bought two. There is one on the bathroom windowsill. You can have a bath looking up just there. Is it watching you while you have a splash around? Anyway, folks, I should throw that around. And before it really does go totally bloody cold, bottoms up. It's so bloody nice, but it's on its way for the sink if I don't drink it pretty soon. Oh, who invented tea? The last thing, don't forget this, folks. I know I keep talking about it. 12 days to go, so you can still get one. And they'll be coming out to you really, really shortly. They're in the process now, being printed and into the big envelopes. I'm winging the way to you. 12 goths, 12 months. When it's opened, I'll open it at this one. And when it's open, it's that size. So, and each page has got a little thing of words that the individual wants to say to inspire you to be who you are. Don't let others put you down. Be who you are. So there you go, folks. Go and get one. It's not going to benefit me, not now. It'll benefit all of us in the long run, because the Sophie organisation works for all of us. So if you can, nip along, 12 days. So you ain't got long to wait. Yes. So folks, yeah, there you go. One or two bits I bought. I know, probably not very exciting. If you know what that blooming stretchy thing is, let me know, because I don't know what the real purpose of it is. Could be a scarf, but doubtful. These other bits, if you want to be a bit freaky, you know what to do now. Just a little jar, water, go off the jar up a little bit. If you want to get a little sticker to put on and write something in Latin, the word spider in Latin or whatever, makes it look like a medical specimen. Get a tea bag, coffee bag, squeeze it out, and then make your cuppa first, squeeze it out and keep patting the label, and it'll look as old as the bloody hills. It'll look Victorian or something. Excuse me, still got this bloody.
That's why I sound very manly.
So folks, have fun. Do some bottling. Go and buy bits and bobs. And get your bloody calendar. Have fun.